Good day, gamers. A few updates to this video. Let's get started. Okay, so folks, in this one, we're going to be taking an image, in this case here, this tile, and we're going to create what's called a tile palette. We're going to start working through like how to actually make our level so it's not just this like formless void. So Ruby actually has something to sort of be on. Okay, so to get started, we're going to go ahead and just create a folder just called like tiles. We can call it tile or tiles. It really doesn't matter. Okay, and then what we're going to do is we're going to be basically trying to keep the images that we are using to create our tiles separate from where our actual tiles are going to live, as well as what's called our tile palette. But first of all, let's go ahead. We've got an asset to import. So let's go ahead and grab this tile, say download image, and then you should be pretty good at this point from like lesson one. Let's go ahead to just art, and we can put it into our sprites and then environment folder. And this is where all of our like kind of raw images are going to live. Let's go ahead then, do a right click, and then we're going to say import new asset. And let's go to our downloads folder and let's grab that tile that we just downloaded. Okay, cool. All right, so now that is ready to go. What we're going to do next is we're going to create what's called a tile palette. And then that palette is going to be where we import this image in so that we can actually, like, you know, populate this level. So I think we'll just go to our tiles folder to start off with. And then let's go to window. And then we'll go to 2D and tile palette. Okay. So this is ready to go then. So what we'll do is we will go ahead and click on create new palette, and we can go with the default options. This palette is going to serve as like sort of like a place where all of the things, like when we want to like sort of draw a level or create an environment, that's where this is going to live. So let's click on create, and let's put it in our tiles folder, which we should be in. So if we look here at assets, let's put in tiles. Okay. And it's going to just live there for now. Now, one thing we're going to also do is we're going to add what's called a grid to our a grid object to basically organize the tiles that we're going to be placing. So let's set aside the tile palette for now. I'm going to go full screen here a second. Let's go ahead and just create a new game object. So let's say game object, 2D object, and we're going to create a tile map that is set to rectangular. This is going to make a grid so that like it's easier when it comes time to like draw the environment, because this is a 2D environment with sort of like pixel art. This tile map is going to sort of organize like how we place our tiles. Very cool. Thank you. So anyways, here is our tile palette now. We've got our tile grid. Let's go ahead to our environment. And let's go to that tile image that we had brought in before. So what we're going to do is just click and drag it into this tile, the tile palette. Go ahead. It's going to say, hey, where do you want to save this? We're going to save it in our tiles folder. Okay. And we'll just keep it. The file name is tile. All right. So when we, so now like it's super easy. We want to draw, like we select this. This is, if you've done the platformer project, we now have something in our tile palette, and we can now sort of populate our grid. So you look at it, and it's like, so let's place a few of these. And you look at it, and you're like, dude, what's the problem here? Why is it not filling the grid? So the main reason is this, is that our image is, let's go ahead here and go to our tile. This information here is critical. So this is the image that we imported. And do we also have information in the actual tile itself? No, we don't. Interesting. So we'll need to play with that then. But anyways, so there's that tile. And let's go ahead here to the back to the environment. Let's go to our tile. And we see here, this is the image that we created our tile from. We look at it here, it's 64 by 64. That means there's 64 pixels by 64 pixels. A pixel is a unit of measurement when it comes to images. And then we look at our grid. Let's contrast that with our tile map, and we see some information related to that as far as like, okay, like what are the size of these, what are the sides of the grids, all that kind of fun stuff. Now, what we need to do is we need to make an adjustment to this tile image that we used to in that we imported and then we created our tile object from, we need to change it where it says pixels per unit. We need to change this to 64. Okay. The reason is that like there's a mismatch. Like, because initially we say here, there's pixels per unit, and each of these squares is one like unit, so to speak. Well, it says that these units are going to be equivalent to 100 pixels. This is 64 by 64. So what we're going to do is we're going to dial this down. We're going to say pixels per unit, 64. And then we can click on apply. And just that easy. It's just that easy, folks. And now we have the image filling the thing. Don't worry about Ruby sort of like hiding behind there. That is okay. That's something we'll fix in the next one. All right, folks. Good stuff, man. Rock and roll.